coming. This is awesome. This is one of many workshops we're going to be doing to support you guys. I want to do intros. I want to know about you guys, your intentions for being here tonight. Just a couple weeks ago, maybe 3 weeks ago, we had, we had Parul Agrawal. She is a graduate of ours. She's also a best-selling author. And she did a workshop on how to become a bestseller, like some of the strategies to get you on Amazon and kind of through the ranks, because there are some algorithms and strategies you can use to do that. The thing is, she's more advanced, having gone through the same sort of process that I went through and then applied even extra knowledge to do bestsellership. So we did record that for you guys, and that would be great to watch. Thank you. That'd be great to watch after this. What I realized was I got a lot of basic questions to even lead up to the point of then bestsellership. So tonight's intention is to really share with you guys how literally in this very classroom, actually, that table, in this classroom is when and where I had an idea, divinely inspired, and it came to fruition as just a project. And then a teacher later, Elmas, asked me to publish it. So then I learned how to do that, and I did the entire portion. I did it all without spending a dime because I didn't have no money to spend. I looked at Balboa Press and I was like, oh my, I can't do that. I can't do that yet. You know, so it's not to say there's not a time and a place. People might have a certain budget that'll support that. However, at the time I didn't. And even now I probably still don't. I don't know. What I learned was, and I'll share this with you guys as we go through the evening, but I've actually recently, it was about a year ago actually, I did an author forum with a woman who was on Oprah twice, and she's traditionally published. And she looked at me and she just said, you are so lucky that you're indie published, that you're self-published. And I inquired as to why, and I'm going to share with you guys tonight the many reasons that she said it's so much better to be self-published. The first thing that goes is marketing. It's up to you to market your book. So you end up paying $1,000 just for the basics of any sort of publishing. Let's say Balboa Press, someone who would typically pick us up in the spiritual realm rather quickly. Even a grand is not paying for your marketing. They're not promoting that for you. So I learned very quickly how to do this whole process without paying a dime. It will cost you time. It'll cost you sweat equity. But it's so worth it. It's so worth it. And so we put in the sweat equity, and our return on investment is all these incredible opportunities to show up, speak about it, do workshops around it, and just even, you guys, there's nothing like literally holding your author proof when it comes in the mail to you. It's the best feeling in the world. Like, it is like second to having children. Even better, because it's a lot less painful. So my intention is to make this like super painless for you guys and show you how you can do this without paying a dime. And then if you want advanced workshops after, when we start talking about the bestsellership and stuff, Parul and I are creating that for you guys, and that's complimentary. That's part of Sweetha's giving back to you guys. We want to see everyone succeed. We want to see you guys take this to the one-to-many model. This is about beyond just paying to swap time and sessions. There's a place for that, and people that are drawn here have a message that's meant for the masses. So let's get that one-to-many model. Let's help multiple people in multiple different sources of income that help us further help people. So with that, we'll start with intros about you guys. I just simply want to know your name, why you're drawn here, and the process you're in. Have you written a book? Do you know you're meant to write a book and you haven't started it yet? Have you already published a book? Wherever you're at with the process. And we'll just start over here with Jeffrey Allen Gray.
Hello.
Mostly because I know your full name.
Yeah. So I'm still at the beginning. I'm writing a book.
Okay.
Is that the only question? I'm sorry.
Yeah. I mean, any intentions for tonight's workshop?
My intention is to get on CreateSpace and start it with you.
Okay, good. Love it. We'll have some action items, too.
Yeah.
So that'll be good. Okay, cool. Thank you, Jeffrey.
Hi, I'm Teresa Cox.
Hi, Teresa.
Thank you. I'm 76 pages into my book, and I started it while I was in life coaching and through that process, if anybody knows what that process was. So I'm excited to get my book out.
Did you start writing during the process?
Oh, yeah.
One of the greatest things anyone can do is write in process. We need not wait until progress. We are the most credible when we capture the process. And so I'll share that with you guys towards the latter end of tonight, too, building what's called the author brand. you know, we're going through so much transformation.
Oh, yeah.
It gets to the point where we can't even identify with who we once were, because quantum changes are happening. So to capture it now, even if you don't publish it, to capture the raw, real emotion, that's good. So it's wonderful that you started during that process, and you said 76 pages in.
Yeah,
76. Woo! I love it. Okay, cool. Thank you, Teresa. Anne Caban.
My name is Anne Caban. I am writing. I started a book in 2010. I put it up on the shelf, and I just took it down. And so I am going to be completing that by the beginning of next year. I'm already scheduled to talk about it.
Yes, you are.
And what were your other questions? What do I hope to get out of this? I know nothing, so everything you have to say will be
love
a
it.
Bonus in my head.
Love it. Okay, cool. Thanks, Anne. Cabano.
You're welcome.
Anne Cabano.
Yes, sir.
We met before. Jason, Bold Aromatherapy is my business, and I have a blog that I publish every Wednesday on WordPress, which is free, by the way. I have a free ebook that I send out in exchange for emails. That book is based upon my blog articles. It's about 30 pages. It's in PDF format.
Brilliant.
And I'm working on putting together a book that I'm going to sell on Amazon or the like, eventually, hopefully within about 6 months' time from now. Once I've accumulated and published enough blog articles,
mm-hmm.
right now I'm just putting together the outline, fleshing that out, the kind of chapters that I want in there.
Love it.
Whole,
yeah.
What kind of messages I want to put out there. So tonight I'll sure get lots more goodies from you about that.
Yeah. You mentioned you're fleshing out and kind of outlining. Are you finding that as you write your blog, you're getting feedback essentially for free? You're seeing what people like, what people don't maybe engage all that much, and that's helping you create it?
In a way, yes.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's just, I have a number of followers, just there's not a whole lot of engagement. I gotta figure out how to
mm-hmm.
engage people.
Yeah.
That's the
yeah.
topic right there.
Yeah. Well, and the good news is you're not alone in that. Algorithms have changed significantly, and it's with the intention of making us pay to promote content. So the good news is there's tons you can do organically, authentically, even on your personal page without having to pay for things, and on your blog, getting it out there. So do not worry. Also, another thing, there are a lot of local news television. They're always looking for something local to highlight. So if you're interested, remind me. I'll email out to you guys, like AZTV. Channel 7, they're constantly doing little 5-minute segments with people that are local. It'd be like the perfect opportunity, especially when you look at, like, similar to a magazine's editorial calendar. News stations will have calendars of when they're featuring certain things, or you can let them know, like, hey, did you know that it's National Aromatherapy Month, right? Mm-hmm. And so you can let them know. The more you educate people ahead of time that we have to constantly be looking about where we are the niche industry, we're the top contributor. So if we're constantly telling people, like, hey, by the way, this is coming up, you might want to feature something about it, and this is why you're going to want to feature me. So we make everyone's job so easy that they have no choice but to bring us on, and that's one of the ways that you can organically get people to visit your blog or utilize, recycle the content that you've created there and use it. So that's a perfect, I love it. I'm glad you're already showing up in that capacity. And that's practicing writing, too. And that's great. So, awesome. Okay, thank you so much, Jason. Yes, hi. Pink shirt.
Oh, hi, I'm Dawn.
Hi, Dawn.
And I went to Tony Robbins' event a while back. And he's like, write a book. So I was like, all right, I'm going to write a book. And ever since then, it's been bugging me. So, and then I watched the video with you and Carol, and that was awesome. So that really got me more motivated.
Cool.
A lot of good info. I wrote it. I was trying to write everything down as you guys were talking. So, yeah, just scared to get more
awesome.
Motivation, inspiration, and
yeah.
knowledge.
Love it. Okay, cool. Thanks, Dawn. Are you a student here?
Yes.
Awesome. Okay, cool.
I just finished life coaching.
Oh, my God. Isn't that delicious?
I was here 3 years ago, but then I quit.
Did you quit?
I didn't quit.
Relationships never end. They evolve.
I didn't quit.
Yeah.
I just postponed for a while.
I love it.
I'm
hey,
back.
That's, is that not life coaching? Honoring
yeah.
where you're at? So, perfect example, right? I love it. Okay, cool, Dawn. Thank you. Yes, sir.
I'm J.R. Whitehead. Thank you for having us.
Yeah.
Just here to learn in the earlier steps, just to soak as much knowledge in as possible, and
JR?
Yeah,
got it. Okay, cool, JR. And are you a student here?
No.
Okay, how did you hear about this?
Facebook.
This is about author building your author brand, right? Letting people know about events that you're hosting. It's a way to get people. So wonderful. Thank you so much for joining us. When you walked in the halls, did you feel anything?
I felt that I was going to the right place.
Yeah. Woo! Sweetheart's known for that. We're not in Kansas anymore, JR. Welcome home. Okay, cool. And what might you write a book about? Give us a little bit about like your background, what you're passionate about.
Passionate about just how to learn as far as, you know, what is up our souls and going to a different level and find something else, find some more goodness from life instead of just the materialism of it.
Mm-hmm.
So it's,
oh, yeah. Yeah, that's Sweetheart, so welcome home, yeah. So higher awareness, right? Soul, love it. Okay, cool. Thanks, JR. I know, right? That's hello.
Yeah.
See ya from now on, because you're home. Thank you. Yes, m'lady.
I'm Susie.
Hi, Susie.
Hi. And I'm assuming the question is why am I here?
Yeah, what do you intend to get? And where are you at in the process? Do you know you need to write a book? Have you started a book? Have you published before?
I've started a book. So I haven't published.
Okay.
And so I'm here basically to learn how to publish once I finish said book, and to also, since I'll know how to publish it, be more motivated to finish the book. And I'm a student off and on, so like I always come back. So.
I love it. Someone once told me, relationships never end, they evolve. And I was like, that'll be me and Sweetheart for the rest of my life. It'll just evolve, come and go. Okay, cool, Susie. Thank you so much. We're glad you're here. Yes, ma'am?
My name is Michelle Root.
Hi, Michelle.
Recent graduate.
Yeah! I know her!
I had a few friends who died from cancer,
mm-hmm.
and I wanted to write a book on nutrition and essential oils and the different aspects of how we can take care of our bodies to prevent or treat cancer.
Mm-hmm.
So I even attended Black Card Books weekend of being published, and thank goodness I didn't spend $30,000 to say yes. So I have a general outline of what I want, but that's about it.
Was the Black Card, is that a traditional publisher?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. He holds a weekend workshop and teaches you all sorts of stuff about how to. And then, of course, he has a package that he'll sell you.
Mm-hmm. And it's $30,000.
And all that, and it's like $50,000.
Oh, I gotta go, guys.
I was there, too. I went to that, too.
That's so wild. I mean, hey, I suppose. You know? Welcome, come on in, no problem.
I have heard of someone who did sign up with him and then
no avail.
Never really got to work.
Hmm. Well, this is the gold card.
Look your computer.
Is that annoying?
It's making you look like you're not there.
An Oompa Loompa?
No.
Or not an Oompa Loompa?
Just not there.
Who's the one that ate the blueberry? Was her name Violet?
Violet.
And she ate the blueberry, right?
Yeah.
I was hoping that's what I was looking like, but I guess not. All right, is that better? Awesome. So, Michelle, thank you. And that's still your passion, that you still feel that's going to be one of the first works that you publish?
Yes.
Okay, I love it. How far are you in it?
I have basically a table of contents and then some little bit in each chapter.
Okay. I love it. Okay, cool. Yeah, there's Randy Davila. He has done many things here. He's a good friend of Casey's. He has Think Like a Publisher. And we've done spirit launches here instead of, we did Spirit Tank as opposed to Shark Tank, where angel investors came in to like consider some of us to invest in. And we were able to pitch our ideas. And I pitched for mentorship like an hour and a half with each of them, and I got it, and it was amazing. And my time with Randy was like incredible. He also said, he gifted me his book and gave me time, and he just said, listen, this is what you need to do to really expand your book. And one of the things is each chapter in and of itself can be a standalone. And we can utilize that, as you know, to be a free ebook in exchange for email addresses to get, you know, the energy going. So one of the biggest things, my takeaways was egos are like farts, I'll explain. I turned that into a workbook, And by adding even questions at the end of each chapter, it instantly adds almost 50% more face value. You're going to get people that are less inclined to share it because they've actually articulated personal things and or they've just written in it so they wouldn't provide that copy. But that was one of the biggest things, too, is when you turn your book into a workbook, just by adding simple questions at the end that are reflective, that alone helps up the price and the just ability for you to share it with multiple people. So that's a great thing to bring up. So thanks. Love it. Hi.
Hi, I'm Laura Vargas.
Nice to meet you, Laura.
Nice to meet you. I was a former student here about 11 years ago.
Cool.
And so I see the stuff on the Facebook. And,
yeah. Welcome back.
I had a micro preemie last year. It was 1 pound, 3 ounces. And so that's kind of part of the process of going through that. I feel compelled to write a book.
Yeah.
So I'm about 2/3 of the way through. And before I started it, I saw a Tom Bird seminar. And I was like, oh, I need to go and hear what he has to say. And it kind of pushed me right along.
Okay, cool.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So, have you been journaling or writing during the process of just the struggles? What's the energy and the emotion behind it?
I did some during the process.
Yeah.
But I can't remember the password to that file, and so it kills me. And every day I try a new password for this file. But a lot of what I've done in the last probably 4 months. Because I'm kind of, he's in a really good place, I'm in a really good place, so I can really kind of purge all of that emotion and trauma. And,
yeah.
It's about spirituality too, and kind of finding my way back to that through this process.
That's lovely. Well, congratulations.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's beautiful. I love it. We all, our mess is our message. We've all had things that we've gone through that are intended for us to share with other people, you know? And it's actually a divine calling. It's like, wow, I was entrusted with this mission, you know? And so who are we not to share that? Every time we share something, I mean, even as you're speaking about that, I think about my son and some stuff that he has going on. And there's like this instant connection and relatability to you as a mother that will never give up.
Mm-hmm.
And it inspires me instantly. And it's like, kindred spirit, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And so by expressing some of the deepest, darkest parts of us that are, you know, we feel no one would understand, there's still relatability in everyone's story that we can connect to. So lovely. Thank you so much. All right, Laura, thanks. Yes, Miss Elise.
Elise Finocchio. I have a whole library of books in my head.
Mm-hmm.
And I finally decided that it's about time to hoard up. So I decided to get it out, put it out. I'm really looking for my first book to be a training book, a massage, because I've been in it for 40 years, so I learned a few things. And I think it's important because there are approaches to massage that haven't been really addressed. And so I said, what the heck? You address them.
Yeah. Right.
Instead of waiting for somebody else to address them and saying, you know, when is somebody going to put this out?
Yeah.
So I decided that that's what I'm going to do. I have outlined the book. And it, like I said, it'll be a textbook.
Mm-hmm.
But it will also be, it's a text workbook.
Good.
Actually, and it's a course that I intend to teach.
Love it. And that's brilliant, Elise, because you'll find that a lot of this content that you create, you can recycle as courses, as modules online for digital courses, as workshops, piecemeal, 8-week workshop, 8 chapters, 8-week workshop, right? So love it. Thank you so much, Elise. Hi, Stephanie.
Stephanie Dully, and I'm finishing up my massage program here.
Mm-hmm.
But my book, what I want to write about, is my experience with overcoming cancer. So that was 16 years ago when I went through it.
That
and it was quite a journey over a 2000, the year 2000 was just a whirlwind of challenges for me. And I received a bone marrow transplant from my sister, and I want her to co-write a book with me. She couldn't make it tonight, she wanted to be here, but because she has a really good memory about a lot of stuff. Mm. And since she was my bone marrow transplant donor, then I wanted to also include her in the book. But I do have a lot of my journals that I wrote through the whole process. I haven't looked at them in 16 years.
Yeah, that's...
But, yeah, I need to go through that. I have all my medical records that my mom saved.
Yep.
So what really inspired me to really do it was Anita Morjani, and I'm not sure if you're familiar with her, but she had a near-death experience, and I also had one, too.
Hmm.
And so to hear her speak at the I Can Do It conference in Philadelphia a couple months ago was amazing, and it really inspired me to I need to get out there and write this book.
Yeah, I love it. And her expressing resonated with you, and then now it's inspired you. So imagine, I mean, people are still being born, folks. People are still experiencing things. And they don't know about the Hay House that we know about. They don't know about the authors that have come before. And those folks are transitioning out. God bless them. So it's our turn to carry the torch and share what we've learned, you know? Not just with what they've offered and what we've learned, but also our own spiritual experience that we've, you know, been through. So, yeah. Thank you, Stephanie. David.
Well, my name is David. Somebody told me to show up with a camera, so that's why I'm here.
Thank you, David.
No, I'm actually co-authoring and editing a book with my dad. And I have a little paper here. So it's tentatively titled Messages from Beyond the Veil. It's a book that centers on messages from spirits who have lived as humans on Earth and who evolved to a purity that allowed elevation to a high proximity with God. So the ultimate goal of these spirits, which should thus be humankind's, is to achieve a spiritual awakening or a critical mass of good. Next.
So in your own words, David, what would you say? So ultimately...
Those are my own words.
Thank you, David. All right. All right. If you were to speak in front of a camera without the paper, like how... Tell them what happened today, the 11 minutes at 11. What did you share?
Well, I mean, if we go back a little bit, as I was working with the material, I was, as we would say at Sweetheart, divinely inspired.
Mm-hmm.
And I had this urge, I needed to share some of the passages. And
these passages you're referencing, they're from like the 1930s?
Yeah, so, I mean, if we go back, it's... my great-grandfather brought with him, when he immigrated from England, a transcript. It was a spiritual group in England in the 1930s, and they were connecting with spirit entities, and they were transcribing this, and it took a process of many, many years until World War II, and they had to end the meetings. And so my great-grandfather was a friend of one of the people in the group, and he was he brought the transcripts with him, and he kept them secret until he was about to transition, and he left the manuscript with my father, and 31 years later, we're finally going to. That was my great-grandfather's wish, was that we publish it. That we publish the messages, because that was also the intention of the spirit messengers.
And if you guys tune in to earlier today, hi, welcome. If you tune in to earlier today on the Sweetheart fan page, we went live during every Tuesday at 11. We do 11 minutes, and it's meditation or what have you. And David read a guided meditation, and it was beautiful. It was definitely channeled. I mean, I was like gone. And it was really something. So how interesting, and what a lovely way to honor his wish.
Well, part of the holdback too is like, yeah, it's great we can do a book, but the publishing aspect, I don't know much about it. was like, okay, but what happens? You make a manuscript and it sits on the shelf or something? So,
and it's so much easier than that.
Yeah, and so I'm starting to learn that it's a lot easier.
Yeah.
Hence the reason I'm here.
Love it.
So.
Cool. Well, hopefully I can make this very, very easy for you guys. So, thanks, David.
Okay.
Shankar.
Hi, I'm a holistic nutritionist and Western herbalist. I actually work in a corporate environment doing computer programming, and so far I had started giving complimentary lectures at my work for the corporate people because they need help and they don't know where to go help, and I found that for the past few months it has been tremendously helping. So while driving down, it struck my head that, well, I could even publish a book specific to the IT community.
Right.
Corporate community, how to be healthy in the corporate while working at your desk all day long.
I love it.
So just a thought came to my head, and I want to see how it can be helpful.
And one of the things, you're already showing up, Shankar, because you're every day you're doing the daily feed,
yes,
which is much like a blog, and
right,
he's sharing that on his Facebook page.
Yeah.
And it's educational, it's informative. People want value up front, and you're
yeah,
giving that to them. You're educating them. So you're already practicing
mm-hmm,
writing,
yeah,
and it's a matter of literally just transcribing it, just
yeah,
getting it in a Microsoft Word document, and
right,
then publishing it. It's
okay,
so simple. One of the things I'm going to talk about, too, because you're doing these workshops,
mm-hmm,
when you guys are speaking about things you're passionate about, just have like an audio recorder,
yeah,
and you could pay someone $5, whatever, get it transcribed, trade someone sessions to get it transcribed. That's how Elmas Vincent wrote his book, Calling All Lightpreneurs.
Yeah.
He kept doing the same workshops over and over again, and so he just decided, you know what, next 2-hour workshop, I'm just going to record it.
Yeah.
2 hours later, sent it off for a little bit of editing, transcribing, there's his book. So when you're finding yourself talking with people about things you're passionate about, it's ideal. Workshops, questions are going to come up. Sometimes we have to go back to a beginner's mindset.
Yeah.
So like questions will come up tonight that if I were writing a book on how to self-publish, maybe I'm not beginner's mindset anymore, so I'm maybe moving a little too fast. Someone poses a question, perfect for that chapter because it's relevant. That's what the consumers are thinking in that moment that you're delivering that content.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like, oh, I'm going to use that question as an anecdote in that part of the chapter. So, I know I'm getting lengthy here, but this is all great. This is good. Okay, so thank you, Shankar, so much. All right, Nicole, hello.
Hi. Well, I'm Nicole, and I'm about to be a great graduate.
Woo! I know!
I know.
So proud of you.
Thank you. I found out I'm prolific. And so, I was told all the time, Nikki, shut up. And I can't stop talking, but it's like, it's awesome, because I think in life you get the messages that you need to, like, here to kind of make you say, I will not set up because I have something to say.
Yeah.
So now I know that I have something to say. Like, I got to like address that and like, thank you. What? How do I say it? So that's what this class is about for me.
Love it. And again, after your workshop that you did right when we graduated from 540,
yeah.
So many classes. Having that, you have it on video.
Yeah.
And transcribing that. Oftentimes, some of us get stuck in writing, so just know that there's a lot of different ways. Some of us, writing is our outlet, but some of us, we can audio record
yeah,
our speaking, because maybe that's how you best deliver. That's how you're divinely inspired. Don't ask me to type. I have to write on paper. If you ask me to type, I'll stop every 5 seconds because my typos are terrible. I'm not a good typer. I'm one of the peckers. Like, and most of the time, it's backspace. So I'm telling you guys, like, find what works for you. Thank you, David. All right, thank you, Nicole. Yes, sir.
My name's Bill. I'm Nicole's assistant, and I need to support her and
I drug him here.
I saw the correspondence on Facebook.
I drugged him.
You know what? That's a compelling story. That's a compelling story. I like it. We'll buy the book.
Support. I've done some writing, blog posts, technical papers.
Cool. Oh, tech papers. Fun stuff there.
Yeah, it's very dry and but it'll help. But I've got some experience with it and just
want
to support.
Love it. Awesome. Beautiful. Thanks, Bill. Hello there, Jez and Jean.
Hi. I'm Jean Giorgiani.
Yeah, you are.
And I have a couple of different writing desires. And one of them is really calling me, but I'm not quite willing to answer that call yet. It's really my life's journey.
Yeah.
But it's pretty gritty. And I'm not kind of ready to put it all out there yet.
Okay.
So I'm kind of like, I feel like God is pulling me, and I'm kind of like, I'm not sure yet.
Hmm.
I even have a title for it. and life coach. Mm-hmm. And I really want to publish an ebook with a workbook as a way of promoting my services mm-hmm. and drawing in new clients. Mm-hmm. So I figure if I start smaller that way,
yep.
while I quit being chicken about the other thing, then we'll make some progress.
I love it. Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jean. Hi.
Hi, I'm Darla.
Thanks,
and I'm going to be writing about team building.
All right.
I was a team building consultant for, I can't tell you how many dozens of years, but you get the idea. And I've written a whole bunch of stuff and a thesis on the 5 major sources of organizational conflict.
A thesis?
Yeah. Which
I'm not qualified to teach you, ma'am.
To temporary or.
Amazing. And you wrote that yourself, right?
Yeah.
Love it. Okay.
So the book is going to be a story about picnic organizers with all the management principles in design.
Oh, I like it.
Combined with the stories of the people that I've met over the years that I coached.
Yeah.
That actually demonstrated.
Love it.
What was happening in the story.
Anecdotes are huge.
And the principles.
Love it. Real-time stories. Who doesn't love that?
Really?
And then we relate. Oh my gosh, anecdotes are huge. If you could have a story, an anecdote, or a metaphor at the minimum
uh-huh.
in every chapter, perfect. Because people will no longer feel like they're just being talked to. They will feel that relatability. So anecdotes are huge. Being able to share stories, not only does it show you credible, but they're able to go, I totally identify with that part of that story. The details don't matter so much. People will, someone could say, tell a story that's unique to them, but we automatically will identify with the emotion that connects us, right?
Yeah.
All of us, I guarantee everyone in this room has experienced to some degree being embarrassed, being humbled, being ridiculed, feeling elated. I hope everyone here has felt elated at some point. But that's the thing is we connect to that emotion. So even if the details, we don't read. We read for entertainment and for emotion, not because we're looking for answers necessarily. The answers are within. So we come to those conclusions based on what people are offering that we can bounce off of. So anecdotes and storytelling is going to be great. Yeah, for all of you. Even if it's metaphors or if it's clients with discretion, of course, right? Client A, client B. So lovely. Thank you so much, Darla. Hi. Nice to meet you.
I was told, I went to Sedona about 10 years ago for a short period of time, and I was told by a psychic there that I had 2 books in me.
Mm.
So, I'm still waiting to see those 2 books. But anyway, I have some ideas, and I've started writing one that turned into a website. So, my book is a website.
Cool.
And, yeah, I didn't have
virtuals.
A magazine published.
I love it. Okay.
And then I am actually writing another one. It's a very, very short one. It's about, it's called My Travel in Sanctuary.
Mm.
Where you can take your sacred space with you wherever you go.
I love it. Mm-hmm. Okay, cool. That one you think is going to be hardback, paperback, and electronic?
The Traveling Sanctuary will be paperback.
Okay, cool. I love it. Thank you, Lynn. Hi, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Good, welcome.
Thank you. My name is Samir. I'm an IT consultant. So someday in future, I feel like I'll be writing a book.
Yeah.
Maybe from my experiences from this life and whatever I've learned from those.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm here to learn a few tips and tricks from you.
Cool.
How to get it for going.
Awesome. You said Samir?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Well, I hope to support that. Thank you. Hi.
Hello, my name is Pinky. It's my husband told that he has a program about how to write a book. So
yeah.
I don't have any idea. I don't like to read books of very, some books I like.
Uh huh.
Not very, I mean, say interesting books I want to read. So I have to learn that how can I write in an interesting way.
Yeah.
So that everybody can read and everybody can feel, oh, it's a good book.
I love that. You'll find that however you speak naturally and how you write naturally, it'll appeal to like-minded people. So that's one thing I've learned in this process too. I mean, I talk about flatulence. Like, I talk about farts. But did you know that my demographic is 60 to 72 year old women? I had no idea. They'll come to you. So just trust that if you show up as the greatest expression of yourself, the like-minded people, they'll flock to you. They'll love the way that you speak. And it'll revert those who aren't interested. So just for whatever that's worth, don't suppress and just show up as you are. So is it Pinky?
Yes.
Love it.
How did you find out that your demographic?
When I started getting a ton of invitations from Unity of Mesa churches, that was like wildfire. They're like, you're the fart lady. Can you come over to our meeting Sunday after our gathering? We have a book reading club. And that spread like wildfire. That was, and then I knew. And they were so candid and willing to do the work and talk about flatulence and how it shows up. So I'll get into that too briefly, but it was just, you'll know, because you keep showing up as the greatest expression of yourself, no pun intended here, and then the people will let you know, hey, I want that. We need that. So, yeah, I know, who knew? Who knew? What the wind blew in. So, thank you, Pinky. Hi, Tammy.
Hi, Tammy Coyne. I have not yet written a book. However, I've done a little bit of writing. I'm a staff writer right now for the Holistic Speakers Guild, so I've done a couple of things there.
Love it.
I do have an entry in the book that Carol is writing, 100 Moms, One Voice, I believe.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
I have been told probably at least once in almost every year of my life that I need to write a book. People hear one little piece of my story and say, oh, you should write a book. I'm like, oh, well, that's just like one day I had, you know. And so I've kind of pushed it off. There's been a lot of information that's come to me over the years, but I wasn't quite ready. Mm-hmm. I'm ready now.
Love it.
I know that there are so many books coming. I don't have a number. I do know there are a series. There's a series coming too.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
You gave me a couple of ideas. There's some things I've written, like even my bachelor's capstone project was even on alcoholism in the United States and alternative treatments, and I had no idea
huh.
in 2003 that this was coming.
Right.
And then, you know, there was a almost death experience. There's been so many experiences. And after I moved here 2 years ago, I started getting these, I'll say, visions of me on the stage. And I didn't know what that was about. Mm-hmm. And then other little pieces came to me about this whole author thing. So now my spiel, I'm gonna see if I can get it out. I am an internationally known speaker, author, master teacher, and healer who is here to use the stories of my life to inspire, motivate, empower, and help people transition their life to the next stage.
Love it.
Woo! So that's what I'm doing, and
yeah.
I'm trying to, like, okay, it's coming at me faster than I can keep up.
That's
so
better than stagnant.
Yeah, exactly. You said stage. Is she the one we were talking about on video?
Yeah.
So you just gave me some ideas. I've been doing Periscopes for over a year. I can transcribe those.
Yeah.
I did a workshop
yes.
recently on Are You Experiencing PTSD After Divorce? I can do that.
Yep.
I've written some little free things for my website. One, I won't say the name of it since we're on video. It might upset some people. The other one is How to Self-Soothe
mm-hmm.
Before, During, and After a PTSD Attack, and that is for people who have gone through childhood trauma and abuse and experiencing it later in life.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, I can get going for a while, so I'll just stop.
Okay, cool. Well, I love it. That's good, Tammy. Awesome. Thank you so much. Hello there.
Hi, I'm Farhana, and just want to thank everyone for being here. It's been really great hearing, you know, your stories and your process. I came from the legal world, and I had a bad accident, and then I did a lot of writing with contracts, and you know, I was like, okay, you know, this is where I can go with my writing, but I really missed being creative and being, you know, writing for me really drawn to writing children books.
Cool.
Because mostly, like, obviously, you know, what I have to say and, like, a bunch of series, but the illustration aspect of it, like, really getting, like, drawings also on the picture. And then, like, just as a child, just trying to figure out who I am and my identity, like, I remember, and then just going, you know, searching through the library as a child, you know, trying to find books to, like,
yeah.
find out, you know. I think a lot of people are, I think, initially are drawn to, like, astrology because you're like, oh, what's my sign and what are, you know, maybe, oh, yeah, that's why I am who I am or whatever. So, you know, I wanted to kind of do children books that kind of have, like, identity, you know, finding your identity.
Oh,
and
I love
stuff.
That.
So, but this is something new to me, something that I've been wanting to do. I wanted to come to a class setting then do like self-learning,
mm-hmm.
you know, by the internet, because you can learn a lot, obviously, by the internet.
Yeah.
But I think this is going to be a process where I want to like learn in a group setting and
yeah.
learn from people and then, you know.
I love that. And I strongly encourage, if you feel drawn to anyone else's story or what have you, to connect afterwards, because it does take people that are supporting you and empowering and encouraging you to stick with it. You could have book buddies that you, hey, where are you at with this chapter? And just keeping each other accountable. So it's something to consider. Thanks,
yeah.
Farhana.
And like, I think like, you know, 10 years ago or so, I don't think like Amazon like had this, like, hey, you know, we weren't able to do this, something like
right.
this.
So right.
even if like, obviously my like intention isn't to sell, you know, that's kind of my secondary, but for me to just even have books on my shelf, you know,
yeah,
like that's like my like dream. So.
I love it. Whatever the, it can be,
yeah,
it can be lucrative.
Exactly.
And it can be loving.
Exactly.
It can be just another thing that you bring into physical manifestation,
exactly.
physical fruition. So thank you so much. Are you ladies supporting, joining?
To bring my sister as well. And
mm-hmm.
also, my name is Farzana. I forgot to introduce myself. I had been a little bit writing and back in high school, like poems, like
mm-hmm.
some like a school project.
Yeah.
And someday I would like to, you know, write like, you know, in a poem and come here to, you know, kind of learn. And I have a learning disability, my speech problem. So it would be like a really good like opportunity to communicate.
Yeah.
Similar to him. And I had a friend who kind of also inspired me. He actually lived in New York City, but he's an awesome object too. So
love
it. I can learn something as well.
Nice.
So.
Yeah, it's been said that we're most like the five people we spend the most time with. And that doesn't mean just in physical vicinity. It could be through audio and books and things. So it's wonderful you have a friend that's inspiring you in that realm. So start seeking more information and guidance from authors that you look to and aspire to. Thank you, Farzana.
And that's my mother for that.
Supporting?
Yeah, she's a great
She's supporter. Gonna be your editor.
Yeah,
and she's gonna let you know.
Okay.
I love the family support.
Yeah.
You'll be
yeah.
in the acknowledgements, Mom.
Exactly. I love that.
Cool. And then you, sir, did you wanna briefly tell us a little about yourself?
My name's James. My wife was here. I'm actually writing a book on relationship with God and
cool.
relationships with each other, stuff like that.
Okay.
That's kind of what I work on.
How far are you in the process?
13 chapters or so.
Nice. Okay. Do you know how long you want it to be? Is
it
evolving?
I'm trying to figure out if I want to do smaller books.
Okay.
Or bigger book. I'm leaning more towards smaller books.
Yeah.
Because people will actually read them.
Right. And so there's something right now that's happening analytics-wise. I'm going to tell you guys, I'm going to balance between like the spiritual, what I believe and what I've seen, and then also the dense energy of algorithms and analytics. And 10 pagers right now are huge. So if you're thinking about doing an ebook or something like a mini chapter just to see the sort of engagement you get, offering a little bit of insight in 10 pages, right now, 10 pages is so hot right now. Like, that's a thing. So maybe condensing just even a portion of it to see what sort of engagement you're getting, and then that might help you shape the rest of the chapter, and you might even find that it becomes a series. You know, you've already got 13, so you could potentially do one a month, and then a bonus, you know, who knows, you know, at the end of the year, what have you. So really, there's so many ways you guys can go about this. So thank you, James. And was there anyone else that didn't share? Everyone's good? We're good? Cool. Okay, so let's see. Okay, I'll quickly give you guys background on what happened here. So I am a nutcase. I am hilarious, I like to think. I'm very humorous, but it wasn't until I came to SWEHA after 12 years as a military police officer where I was very rigid and would not laugh, and I was not myself. I suppressed myself. It wasn't until I found SWEHA that I could be the greatest expression of myself. And in these halls and in these classrooms, everyone knows that's been here, and if you haven't, well, welcome home. You'll find out soon enough. Audit any of our classes. Take a class, 4 hours for complimentary, first 4 hours. There's a space here that allows you to really be yourself. And so I would start to have like these obnoxious little jokes that I would say, like these little pieces of me would come out. And then more, before I even knew it, that was invited. So who you are authentically is the greatest expression of yourself. Being passionate, that is how you have to show up. It's gonna be great for a million reasons. Number one, you're gonna find that it's gonna flow. Your writing is gonna flow that much more so because you're actively inspired, you're in spirit, you're connected to who you were created to be or who you created yourself to be, whatever you believe, okay? So tapping into those things that are innately you, that's gonna make your writing so much easier. Secondly, you're not gonna have to hire someone to market for you and brand yourself in a way that's gonna appease to this crowd and this crowd and this crowd. Just be you, show up, and I'm telling you, like-minded people will be attracted to that. They'll be attracted to that. So your voice is perfect the way that it is. Your story and how you tell it is perfect the way that it is. Outside of maybe a little bit of editing, I'm telling you, this is very balanced. This is not all numbers, it's not all cookie cutter, it's not all algorithms and analytics. I worked at an agency for 3 years before I came here to SWEHA. And yes, man has made computer software that'll tell you certain keywords are hot in this moment and that there's opportunities to, you know, post at this time of day, but at the end of the day, you know what software doesn't do? It doesn't engage like a human. It doesn't respond on your behalf to build that rapport, and that's what we're ultimately doing when we write a book and we share our works, whether it's a book, a blog, what have you. We're trying to connect. That's what we're trying to do. So in your book, be you, that will connect to the right people. And you don't have to worry about trying to appease all these other people. Your author platform is who you are innately. So I started to share my humor. We had an exercise, it was in this class, it was HN120. It was the very beginning transformative nutrition. It was like before you start the nutrition track. And I was having a hard time grasping the ego because I have a huge one. And I didn't want to acknowledge it or observe it. And so what happened was we were invited to come up with whatever creative way we wanted to write and express about ego and separating from that or distancing ourselves from it, right? And so in my humor, somewhat crass approach, I compared it to farts. I said that egos are like this natural expression. It's just something that happens in this human experience, and we can be a little bit more mindful about how we air it, okay? So I started to understand, like, okay, my opinion sometimes really can put distance between me and other people, as can flatulence. So then what happened was I just wrote these down. It was part of a school project. The 9 comedic comparisons came in, and it just like overtook me. Submitted my paper, didn't even think twice, okay? I was just doing my homework, having fun, being the greatest expression of myself, not holding back. Elmas Vincent, who teaches here and who did Calling All Lightpreneurs, and he actually digitally recorded when he was over at workshops and things and had that transcribed into his book. He said, Stevie, you gotta publish that. I'm like, how do I publish it? It's like 9 chapters, a couple sentences. And he goes, well, you just go to createspace.com, and that's what I'm going to show you guys. There might be other avenues, but I'm going to show you guys createspace.com because I'm just going to tell you guys exactly what I did, and it might differ a little bit for you, but I'm telling you, this didn't cost me a dime. So if I can help you guys save money in the process, like, why not? So createspace.com, and I'll pull this up here in a minute, but this is going to be one of the options that exist to publish for free, okay? And I'm going to walk you guys through the whole thing, and it's not going to take long at all. So basically, I sat down, and there were these comedic comparisons, for instance. We all have our own unique essence. This is about our opinions, not just flatulence. We can get a set of rosy cheeks, which is when we embarrass ourselves after saying something. It can be hard to clear the air. silent but deadly. That's when we have internal dialogue that we're not good enough or that we're better than somebody else. And so all of these, I just simply asked a friend in class, Brett Black, he's a graduate here. I said, hey, can you draw me pictures that would associate with these little chapters and these little pieces here, these little comparisons? And he's like, yeah. So then he drew the pictures. Then I went to Eckhart Tolle and Deepak Chopra and all these other people that have talked about ego, and I found quotes that they had said that was relevant to my metaphor. So I was like, oh my gosh, this is brilliant. Like, I just put myself on that level with flatulence. Like, it was great. So at the end of each chapter, you'll see that there's pieces here from Eckhart Tolle, Ellen DeGeneres, Deepak Chopra, Oprah, the people who essentially I wanted to say, hey, I wrote about you. What do you say I come to your show? So there was strategy, but I was just having fun the whole time, okay? So Elma said, go to create space and put it together. So that's what I'm going to show you guys is literally we're going to create a book, like right now, okay? We're just going to do it. I'm going to show you guys. And then this, like, bank tube is going to come out, and then our book's just going to be, I'm just kidding. That'd be great if it was that fast. Okay, so... And if you guys have computers, you're welcome to go to them. But I just want to walk you guys through this. My intention is to show you how absolutely easy this is. And if you guys have questions along the way, if I don't know the answer, I'll tell you the answer. After I get it. Like, I'll seek, I'll find, and then I'll let you know. So basically, you go to createspace.com. You can see I already have my email and stuff logged in here because... once you get started writing, you can't stop. And once you get published, you're like, oh my gosh, I gotta do another one. So you'll see in here a couple of different titles I'm working on. and you'll notice they say incomplete, and that just means that I've yet to actually say, like, okay, I'm done, I want the author proof. But I want us to create one together so you guys can see how easy this is, okay? This is what you guys are gonna do. You're going to leave here and you're going to go on to createspace.com. It's free. It's free. And you're going to set up an account. And then this is the first thing you're going to see. You're going to see your member dashboard. And we're going to go to add new title. Now, I will say this. When you're creating a book, it gets almost like a social security number, if you will. Okay? It's an ISBN. Okay? So that ISBN is essentially how people scan, and then it's the one social security card for your book. Okay, so no matter where it's distributed, if that's pinged, they know everything they need to know about it. They can order it, what have you. Parul, when she did her advanced workshop that we did, she mentions that you could buy an ISBN for $100, and you can. And what that'll do is it'll allot you the opportunity to go outbound to even more resources. There's other sources you can go to, so it'll expand your distribution. I like free when I first started out. So what I would recommend is you do this free first without your title, not the title you want to use, okay? My suggestion is to make a title just to get through the process and see how not a big deal this is. It's so easy. And then when it comes time to actually put yours on, you can decide if you want to pay the $100 for the ISBN. You can decide if you want to just use their formatted template here. They give you a book template I'm going to show you guys. And then you can take that and you can share that with a traditional publisher, whatever you want to do. But let's use this to create a template and make it a less intimidating process, right? Okay, so we're tracking, right? We go on to createspace.com, we log in, we go to member dashboard, new template. Okay. Let's name our project. Dave and Die.
Eggos taste like farts. No?
Okay. Eggos taste like heaven. That's lovely. Okay, thank you, David. Okay, so Eggos taste like heaven. A documentary by, no, just kidding. Okay, so we're gonna choose paperback, all right? Now you'll notice here there's also options for audio CD. This is great for hypnotherapists or any of you that are also looking into other options that you want for audio. DVD and stuff, I haven't even gone down that route. Maybe we could do an advanced class later. So let's just hit paperback. We're going to do super, super simple, okay? Now, we can choose to go to expert, which this in a little bit would ask you to pay money for assistance, or we could just try it on our own first because it's really not that difficult at all. I did this, like, seriously, at coffee shops with, like, I just figured it out. And so if I can do it, I know you guys can. It's so simple. So we'll go to a step-by-step process with help along the way. Now, the help is not going to, you don't have to pay for it. The help is like little thumbnails that pop up and say, by the way, Stevie, check your formatting, girlfriend. Okay? So it's like super, super simple. So now it prompts us, it says, okay, title information. Eggos taste like heaven. What is my subtitle? Now let me tell you guys this about your title and your subtitle. You want something that pops, maybe no more than 5 words for your title. Okay, this is like what's trending now. This is stuff that I've heard at different publishing workshops. No more than 5 words. It pops, the title pops. A subtitle is where you tell people what's in it for them when they read it. So Randy's book, Think Like a Publisher. And it's got like the exclamation point, so it's really like, ooh, in your face, right? Think Like a Publisher, 33 essential tips to write, promote, and sell your book. So now I know what's in it for me if I get this book. So your subtitle is important. And so what I did was, okay, egos are like farts. People are like, that's, you got my attention. Why on earth would I buy that? And then it says, a comedic approach to compassion for self and others. Okay, so now it's like, okay, I think I get it. It's going to be about compassion and self-inquiry, self-discovery, being kind to others and myself. Got it. So we want a subtitle that's going to tell people what is in it for them. Okay? So what is Eggos Taste Like Heaven?
It's a horrible title.
A horrible title. A horrible title, but a lovely recipe. Right?
Sure.
See, I'm not allowed to type.
Or Eggos Taste Like Heaven with spinach.
What is it? A quick breakfast? I love it. A quick breakfast. Okay, see, so simple, right? So now we're going to put in our author piece. Mr., Mrs., Doctor, whatever, right? Let's put in Stevie. Let's put in, and this is how you want this on, well, you can sometimes change it on the book, but this is going to automatically populate how it would show up on the book. So just think as if this is going on the book, okay? Someone shout out your last name.
Cabano.
StevieAnne Cabano. Okay, so authored by, you can do all sorts of different things, illustrated by, da-da-da-da-da. I'll show you guys later where you can do that. We're going to go to, let's say we have multiple, we've done revisions and things, or additions, you can add here. Know this with CreateSpace. You can go back at any time and revise anything you want. You just have to go back through the process of uploading your new interior. They ask you to kind of check everything over again, and then they resend you your author proof, which is your first hard copy in the mail that you look at and you go, oh, I did it. That's the author proof. So, and you get your kids to capture that because it's like one of the most incredible moments of your life. So, language, English. What's really cool is CreateSpace will later, they're connected to Amazon and Kindle and all these other places. And what's cool is they automatically transcribe it for you in Japanese and a couple other languages. Now listen, they do that automatically, but can I tell you one of the biggest secrets that I learned with authorship is you celebrate everything like it was nobody's business. When Amazon is part of CreateSpace, like it's gonna go on Amazon no matter what. But the day that I got an email that said, your book is now available on Amazon, oh my gosh, you would have thought like the heavens had opened. I did a post about it, and I my verbiage was, Amazon picked up my book! Why not? Why not? I was stoked. I was so excited it was on Amazon. So, you know, have fun with this and celebrate every little piece that you guys can. So the publication date, you can go ahead and select something for, you know, today, the future. This is where you get the little guided pieces, okay? When you click this link, it'll tell you what's going on and if you need to, like if you have any more questions, you can reach out to them, but typically they're gonna answer it right here in these little pieces. So the publication date can't be changed after you submit the book for publishing. If you're republishing, you wanna go with what was originally published. So I've republished this once I got endorsement from Pam Grout. She's the number one New York Times bestselling author. I'll tell you guys how that happened. It was amazing, didn't pay a dime. I redid my cover and went through the whole process again to add that, because you wanna add that, right? So I went with the original published date of June 4th, 2013, 14. So, we can leave this blank also, and it'll actually assign it when you're ready. So your best bet is to just leave it blank when you're doing this template one, right? This rough draft. So we're gonna go to save and continue. So exciting. Okay, ISBNs. So this is something you guys are gonna wanna read about and figure out if you wanna pay the $100 for an ISBN that's expanded distribution, or since you're just doing a rough draft to make this process less intimidating, let them create an ISBN for you. It's not your title, okay? So, and it's not like they have rights to anything until you publish, and that's when you wanna look at the ISBN, because it would be under Create Spaces ISBN that they give you, and you still have rights. They'll give you those options as you continue forward. However, you're limited to how many distribution channels you can give it to, okay? So have fun with this one. So we're gonna go to free Create Space Assigned ISBN, which is what Egos Are Like Farts is. I've not had any issues getting it. I buy copies and I resell them as I deem fit all day long, no big deal. I've not had an issue with, oh, I can't put it in that place because it's because of the ISBN. That hasn't been an issue for me. So we'll just let them create one, assign it for free. And so now this is our ISBN for Eggos Taste Like Heaven, okay? It's official. So we'll hit continue. You can write this down. They'll save it for you. This is what'll populate on the barcode every single time. If you guys want more information about ISBNs, they give you tips and ideas. There's community discussion, so you can get on here and you can talk to people about any questions you have. But this is super simple. Okay, so we're just going to continue with our ISBN. All right, so now we have a serial code for Eggos Taste Like Heaven, and now we get to pick what type of interior type we want. And this will start to, they'll start to tell you like how much the pricing is going to be towards the latter end. They have to know how many pages you're going to have, and that's when we discover how much it's going to be. Okay, so I just went with like black and white. For a while, I did the cream, so it's like a creamier page color, and you might find that given the energy and the dialogue and the context of your book, that supports it more so. You can get author proof sent to you, and so you can see what they look like in real time in your hand and make that decision. Let's just say we go with black and white, okay? I stuck with 6x9 just because that's what this is. So if you, like, I'll send this around. You guys can see, like, this is, to me, it's like you throw it in your bag, it fits in any laptop, it fits in a Kindle thing, like, it's small, and it's the first one that they populated as a template, so I just stuck with it. Now, what's cool, though, is you'll notice you can choose different sizes. So pick a size, any size that you guys think might be, that you might like to hold. Some of you are doing textbooks. Maybe you want a little bit bigger, right? So what size did you guys say?
8x10.
8x10.
Can you change it and, like, do landscape? Or does it have to be portrait?
That is a good question. Let's see.
I think you can, because Perul's isn't traditional in shape.
Yeah.
More.
It's lengthier, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Wider.
Yeah, it says more sizes down there.
Boop. Well, let's look. Look at that. You can customize it.
Yeah.
Hey-o! Now, I wouldn't be surprised if maybe there is a little bit more money to do that, but let me tell you guys, I went with like the minimum pages that you can do. I think the minimum you can print is like 26 pages. After I had the about the author and all the other stuff that goes with it, it's like 30 something pages. It's $2.15 per book for me to buy from Create Space, and then I sell them for anywhere from 10 to 14 depending on where I'm at. I co-sign them at, you know, like Lucy's Healthy Marketplace, and that's what's great about being indie published is you decide. You decide how much people are going to pay. You decide where you're going to sign and where you're going to go. One of the things, too, this woman, Dr. Kathy McCoy, she did Purr Therapy, and it was about her cats and how they helped her in her therapeutic practice, and she was on Oprah twice. The day of our author panel, she was still waiting for her publisher to send the book. There was so much back and forth. Like, she had to contact them, make sure that they had it at the event in time, delivered to that address. It was hardly worth all of it. And then they take a ton of that money. And she was doing all the work. And here I am just showing up with a cardboard box, 50 books, like, ready to go. It's insanely easy. And it's so much better. The profit alone, the return, is ridiculous. So let's just say we wanted to customize, I'd be prepared to maybe pay more. I'm just gonna go back and I'm gonna go to 6.9 again. So here's what's really cool, and this is the one thing that if you do nothing else with Create Space, please do this. When you pick the size of the book that you want, it's going to offer you guys either a blank template or a formatted template. I had no idea what went in a book. I didn't know if acknowledgments went in the back. I didn't know if about the author went in the front. I didn't know any of that. But guess what? This tells us. It's already a template for us. You literally just sit down and type in place of where they put insert text here. It's so simple. So you'll notice, ta-da, I downloaded that, right? I clicked it to download it. So now I'm going to open it for you guys. This is the best part. Because if nothing else, you literally almost have a book right now, right here. It makes it so much more real. Okay, so you enable editing, and now you just start plugging away. And you start typing in everything exactly where it goes. So do you see how this is already formatted? It's like already official. You're like, oh my gosh, it's already starting to look like a book. This is great. I can totally be serious and taken seriously, you know? What's my name? Stevie Cabano, for the purposes of this workshop. So then, listen, I didn't know about table of contents. I didn't know about any of that. Now, what's really cool is because this is a formatted template, when we go to upload it into Create Space, it's already as clean as it's going to possibly be. There's no formatting issues. The sizes and stuff fit. Yes.
Are you completely locked in, or can you kind of adjust things?
Oh, you can adjust many times over. I have many times over. I've added different anecdotes, like as things have happened in my life, like I've added other little, I'm like, oh, that would be really comical. One time I changed the whole book to be a Christian point of view, just because, I don't know, that was a part of my life that I was going through, and I thought, you know what, I'm going to tailor this to Christ consciousness and compassion. And so there's, yeah, you can go in and change it as often as you want. Once it's published, that's when you kind of redo the process of adding a new interior. And so we'll get to that too. So love the question. Yeah, have fun, change it up. At this bottom page, they do like the whole copyright. So you just literally change it, 2017, author name, right? The ISBN, they'll plug that in for you automatically, and or you could populate and put in one that you purchased and or the one that they provided you for free. And you just keep scrolling up. Oh look, dedication. I wouldn't have even had a dedication if they didn't tell me to have one. So then I put my dedications in here. And that's when I was just like, oh my gosh, thank you so much, all these people, Southwest and the Healing Arts. That almost became longer than the dang book. So that was really cool. I would not have known to even put that there or where it would have gone. I wouldn't have known that, but they already had this template. So then we continue to scroll down. Oh look, table of contents. That's important. I didn't know that. So table of contents went right there, and I just inserted the chapter. It looks just like this as you guys are seeing it go around. I took out page number because I kept changing it so much. I don't want to keep changing the page numbers. So now I just had, I mean, and literally every chapter is a page and a half. So it's a small book. So I didn't feel it necessary to do the page numbers. So I just did 1 through 10 and then the chapter names. So it's perfect. And you can change this. However, there's acknowledgments. Little different than a dedication. So, who knew? I would have thrown it all together. It would have been a mess. Like, thank you for all the, it just would have been a mess. I don't even know. Would have like run into the table of contents. Like chapter 5, the thank yous that I forgot at the beginning of the book. Like, who knows? So then, look it. Chapter name. Delete that, put in the chapter name, and then now put all your text right here, right? So it goes on to do this. So simple, you can add, you can change, whatever. You get all the way down to the bottom.
So if you're on chapter 1 and you want to type more than the pages they have, does it just continue or does it?
Oh yeah, it's a Microsoft Word document. You just keep on going. Yep. And then at the very end, about the author. I wouldn't have put that either. I would not have known. And because it kept it short like that, I didn't ramble on either. I kept it like really short and succinct. I think in the back I put, You always want your about the author that's in the back of the book to be relevant to the chapters that preceded it. It's not like about the author big, big, big. It can be, but ideally it's about that book in particular. And so I put something like, Stevie is your typical human being who experiences gas and gossip like everyone else. Like, it was relevant to the book itself. Short, sweet, to the point. So that I learned just by looking at how small this was. And then that was that. So I thought, okay, so at a minimum, if we want to add certain things, sure. But at a minimum, this is a formatted template. This is, if I just do that alone, I have a book. So do that alone, and you have a book. So that's that. So, questions? Yes?
I already have my book on Word. Can mm-hmm. I just copy it?
You totally can. And then, yep, and then what's going to happen is we're going to go into Interior Designer. And so when you upload it, it's going to show you a digital copy of what it would look like. And if there are any formatting issues, it'll tell us. It'll alert us. So so I'll show you guys that next. Jeffrey?
When you added your pictures,
mm-hmm.
how did you do that?
So I had them created by Brett. Then I went to upload them, and it would prompt me and say that, hey, they're a little fuzzy. And so I reached out to like some community help, like, hey, it's saying my images are fuzzy, what do I do? And they said, get someone to vector them for you. And so I traded someone for testimonials. Let me tell you, bartering is huge. Like, I love it. I was just like, hey, can someone vectorize my images? I have no idea what that means. I was like, I need somebody to vectorize these. And I was like, I'll give you a testimonial. And I was like, that's the best vectoring I've ever seen in my life. But basically, just went in and like made the pixel quality that much better. So so I just asked on Facebook, and Jessie Cleveland, she works here, and she has several books, one of which is Northside. They're these huge, amazing sci-fi wolf novels. They're incredible. And her buddy who did the cover of her book, Jeff Hayes, he vectorized my pictures. And so then it was easy to attach. You just literally attach them, upload them. It's that simple.
But then when you want to put them in a certain place in your book,
you can do that. Yep, I just did it based on the Microsoft Word document where I wanted it. Yeah.
So just copy the image and paste it in that place?
Yep, in the Word document, wherever you want it.
Yeah.
And then when you upload it, the Word document, it'll see the images. Okay. Yeah. So, okay. More questions?
Thank you.
Okay.
Okay.
Anne, come in.
So I work on a Mac, and although my pages translates, you know my question?
I don't know the answer, though.
Okay.
Wait, what's the question?
So the pages in Mac is sort of like the equivalent to Microsoft Word.
Oh, I know. I hate pages.
And so it's...
What's it called? Pages?
Pages.
Well, let's inquire within.
Save a document and pages into Word.
You will need Microsoft Word. So you know what?
That's
when
it.
You barter with me. And for a massage, I'm willing to use my computer.
You do massages?
Yeah, she does. Woo. Good stuff. So barter. Ask someone if they're willing to just lend you their computer, transfer it over, or what have you. Now, does it allow us to transfer? Can you copy and paste, save it in a something?
Well, you can save it into a Microsoft document on the Mac, but the formatting's a little jacked.
Okay, James, do you know?
You can get it off of 365 for about $10 a month.
Oh.
Which has Word and Excel.
Oh, well, there you go.
For Mac.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay, cool. So
Office
365. $10 a month, and then now you have access to Microsoft Word. Okay, so that's that. Good question. Good to know. CreateSpace got to get on it. Okay, so now we take our Microsoft Word document. We've been working on this offline. We've been setting aside time for ourselves to plug this in, and now we're like, okay, you know what? I think I'm ready. One of the things I would highly recommend you do is also print out your Microsoft Word document and just hold that. It's a manuscript, you guys. It's a manuscript. Like, holy crap, we made a manuscript. That's a big deal. Celebrate it. Let people see this thick, amazing manuscript and your title and your name, and you do a post and you say, holding the first official manuscript.
Yeah.
I've done that every single time. I've had like highlighters and all my here goes. I celebrate every part of it. And what you're doing is you're getting people invested in the process, and so they're much more inclined to invest in the progress because they feel like they were a part of that journey with you. So Look it. Do not read this. It'll set you free. I love that. Isn't it nice carrying that, like, on your person?
Well, look at me. I'm just gleaming.
I know. It's like the next best thing. I love it. Yay, manuscripts. So, once we're in here, I want to go back. Okay. So let's say we chose six and nine. We got our formatted template. So now we go, okay, I'm good. Thank you. I'm ready to upload my book file. So now I'm actually finalizing my second book. It's a squeakquel to Egos Are Like Farts, and it's called I Just Shift My Cans. And so play on poop humor, because that went really well. So I'm just going to keep going with it. Maybe not for you guys, but the 60 to 70-year-old women, they love me. So I'm going to give them more of what they want. So now it's a comedic approach to conscious self-talk, okay? So this is like, we're going to enable editing if we want. We're going to save this. So now, I'm just going to save this to the desktop real quick so we can upload. And this is, you know, this is just Microsoft Word. You just, it's so easy. Save. All right, so now it prompts us to browse whatever it is that we want to upload. Any questions?
Yeah.
I don't have time for that. Just joking. Yes,
time.
Jeffrey.
Do that one more time.
Do what?
What you just did.
Saving the document?
Yeah.
Oh.
Well, you just browse, look for it. I got it. Never
mind. Yeah, you browse and look for, yep, I was saving it to the desktop so I could put it in here.
It automatically makes you, doesn't it?
What file are you?
Wait, I'm sorry. I'm using a Microsoft Word document that I saved to this. This is the Sweetheart computer, otherwise it'd already be on my laptop. So that's why I was saving it to this desktop really quickly, so that we can upload it. Does that make sense? And it's a Microsoft Word document. Does that answer your question?
Well, we don't need a Microsoft if we're doing it just on here, right? I mean, we're not going to be uploading the document.
You will need a Microsoft Word document. Yeah. That's what you have to download, the template, in order to plug in. Mm-hmm. It doesn't work where you can actively type on it as you're going, which is probably a good thing, though, because if you lost connectivity, that would kind of stink. So, you will want to document or pull a document, mm-hmm, and then plug into that. And then you'll upload it when you're ready. So, your question?
Jeez,
not
that.
Is that, are we good?
So what about the template, though? I thought the template is where you type.
Yes, which is a Microsoft Word document, the template. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I saved the template, the formatted template. I saved that onto my desktop, and then after I started working on it, I just changed the name of it. It's no longer template. It's now I Just Shift My Cans, formatted template. Yeah. And then there's plants, which I'm not working on. I don't know whose that is. We can upload that. Okay. So we have I Just Shift My Cans. So now I'm gonna open this. I've browsed, and I want to upload this book file. So we've been working on this Microsoft Word document. We're feeling really good about it. We're not even done yet, but we just want to see what it's going to look like, right? We just want to see digitally what it will look like. So we go to, now listen, starting at $199, you can talk to a professional design service person. Do it for free first. You can do this on your own, and I'm a phone call away. So you go to save. And so this will take a moment. It's going to upload our Microsoft Word document that we've now been typing into. It's going to upload it into this interior file design thing, okay?
Would you also have your cover in there when you upload it, if you've created a cover?
After this, it'll prompt us to create the cover, and we'll do that together. Yeah. And then it'll always be in there. Mm-hmm. Yeah, like it wouldn't be on your Microsoft Word document. That's solely the interior. Mm-hmm. And they have tons of designs for the cover that we're going to look at. They have templates, and then you could plug in your own pictures, all that. So what other questions while this is converting?
How does CreateSpace like allow this to be free to the public?
I think a lot of people probably pay for the professional services. I don't know that they need to, but I think a lot of them do, because this can seem overwhelming. But if you have buddies, why not work with each other and, you know, support each other in the different areas that you're strong? I did reach out to Almas a few times when I had questions, like, what about the ISBN? And so now I'm learning. And this is very basic. Parool, and, you know, I highly recommend you check out the YouTube, the Sweetheart YouTube channel, because we uploaded her Parole's best-selling author workshop that she did for 2 hours. It's after this part. It's after you've literally created it. It's about how then to market it. But one of the first things she speaks of is the ISBN and how what you do in the beginning helps you further expand in the future. So it'd be good to check out her 2-hour workshop. Tons of information there. My intention, if nothing else, was to show you guys that if nothing else, if you go on to CreateSpace and get that formatted template, you basically have the outline of a book. And just plug something in there. Even an ebook. A simple ebook, you know?
Yeah, that's what I want.
Shankar.
So this one can, will it also convert to a PDF document? As
yes.
Ebook,
yep. So you can save it as a PDF.
Okay.
You know, you could save the Microsoft Word document even that you're playing with. You can save that as a PDF. This will also go to Kindle for free, so it can be electronic. And that's a huge thing, and we learned about that with Parole. Listen, you guys, I'm still in baby stages too. Everything that's happened so far, all was just like trial and error. Like, I'm just showing you guys baby steps, how to get it in print in your hand. And it's so simple. And then from there, you can start to network and work with people to really expand it. So,
yeah.
Question, David?
Nope, I'm just zooming in.
Okay, so now it says that it's in there, okay? Their automated print check didn't find any issues. Granted, I've changed it, you know, based on feedback. But this here, we want to review it. I want to launch this so you guys can see it. If there were any issues, it would tell you right here. It'll tell you that during a certain part of your Microsoft Word, let's say on the second page, you started the next paragraph a little too high. It'll let you know that it's outside the lines. And it'll take you directly to the area in question. And then the thing is, you have to take notes because then you have to exit out. So I would take notes of all the things it said I needed to correct. And then I would exit out, fix it in my Microsoft Word document, and then re-upload the Microsoft Word document. You can't fix it within, which is another reason why they can probably offer it for free, because it does take sweat equity.
Plus, they're going to be the ones that are selling your book.
They get royalties.
Yeah.
When people buy it through CreateSpace or through Amazon, they get royalties. So, and their royalties are, I mean, it's not bad at all. You know, you still get much higher than most traditional publishing. But also, I buy in bulk. And then I go door to door. I do the selling and the book signing, etc. So that's what you guys can do. And then you'll profit way more. So let's launch Interior Reviewer. And this is really cool. So it's going to tell you, so review manuscript issues. It'll tell you if there's any undesired formatting, anything that's not really looking good or it's outside the lines. It tells you that you should address all the errors and the warnings before you move on to the cover, creating the cover, because addressing these now will help you pass file review by our formatting experts. So this does go for free, goes on to formatting experts, because they don't want you buying a bunch of books and then sending them all back. It costs them to print. So they'll tell you, like, hey, we noticed this formatting's a little off or whatever, okay? So then we go, so let's go to Get Started. Now we're seeing, oh my gosh, it's almost even more a book, right? Like, now it's like digital. Look, it has like an outline. This is so exciting. So sans cover, now we're like, oh my gosh. Look at that. Oh, okay. I like the placement of that. I like where dedication starts. If I wanted that to start lower, like eye level lower, whatever, middle, then I would go into my Microsoft Word document and I would bring it down, okay? You'll notice that on Egos Are Like Farts, the pictures, I tried to keep them on opposite pages, and I wanted conscious crop dusting. I wanted the workbook part on a separate page. I didn't want them on the same page as the image. So in here, when I saw that sometimes it would overlap, I was like, nope. So I'd go back into the Word document and I would separate that, okay? So now this one is just like a working, I'm still playing with it, right? But you can see how it's giving us an idea. I haven't put the acknowledgments in yet, but you can see, okay, that's where intro, I like where intro starts. Maybe I should go back and move dedication down to where intro is, just for that like continuity throughout, right? But now we're seeing what it's going to look like electronically. See? And it's like, oh my gosh. So now this is what it would look like in our hands, right?
So for your workbook pages with the lines and stuff, did you literally go in there and like do lines?
I did on the Microsoft Word document. Mm-hmm. Okay. Yep. So now we have this, right? And we go, okay, I feel really good about this, okay? So let's go to save and continue. Again, if you wanted to make any changes, you would just click here, go back and make changes, okay? So I'm gonna save and continue. And now it should populate the portion that says, let's get started on your cover. Now again, if you wanted to launch a different, if you wanted to add a different interior, or you've updated your Microsoft Word document, or you added a really cool story that's relevant, or something just happened yesterday and you thought, oh my gosh, that was what I wanted for chapter 9, you just go back up here to edit your interior details and you resubmit the additions that you've made, the revisions you've made on your Microsoft Word document. It's so simple, you guys. So then we go, okay, let's continue. So excited. Let's get this party rolling. Now we get to pick cover options. Let me tell you what I learned about matte. The matte cover, hands are filthy. And the matte cover, when it was this, I loved the feel of it. It felt velvety, but oh my gosh, in the Sweet Hop bookstore, I was always swapping them out because it had these like thumbprints on it. It would pick up on everything. So I instantly, after like these literally second order, I've probably placed over 8 orders now of 50, and this is all organic. I've not even tried, you guys. I'm telling you, there's a calling for everything that you have to share. After the second time that I got those, I was just like, oh, glossy. And I don't even know if I was paying any less than $2.15 a book. I don't even know that it costs more, because even to this day, I pay $2.15 for a copy. So if it's any less for matte, I say go for glossy. Like, so what you guys see wherever the book's at, that's glossy, and that's, it's good. The matte, ugh, I don't know. Question? No. Okay. So choose how to submit the cover of your book. So again, starting at $399, you can have someone assist you with the cover. Before you even do that, check out the cool templates that they have, you guys. So go here. Let's build our cover online for free. Let's say you already have a print-ready PDF cover that you've had designed. You can upload that. That's fine. But let's just build our cover online. Something that looks like Echoes. Okay, so you'll notice they have a bunch of different options. Look it. Oh, my gosh. It's so attractive. Which one are you guys drawn to? The next page. Love that authentic dialogue. What are we feeling? Let's go to another page. Ooh! Look at, I like the top, this purple.
Yeah.
Just how it kind of has like a, right? Okay, we're doing it. Looks like an echo.
Yeah, purple. Put a waffle right in the middle.
Let's do it. Okay, so now it's giving us an idea of what it'll look like. Echoes taste like heaven. Okay? Oh, look, Stevie Cabano. Look it. That's where that could be, right? Okay? So this is really cool. It literally step-by-step, you guys, guides you on what to do first. So first and foremost, this is our theme. If at any time after you started plugging these things in, you want to change up the theme and check something else out, you just click it, and it'll automatically populate that for you, and you might find, like, oh, my gosh, that does work better. I do like that placement better. So, okay, so let's just say we're going with this shadow play theme, right? Boop. Title, good to go, still there. Now let's say we wanted to add our subtitle because for whatever reason it didn't populate because we didn't write one on the first page, but now we know we want one. What do we say? Eggos taste like heaven.
Good breakfast.
Okay? So now we hit apply. Ew, it's tiny. Overflowing text. You've entered more text than fits into the layout. To fix this, edit the text. Edit the text to make it shorter. Okay, so that tells us that wouldn't work with this one. Okay, so maybe we go and we change the template. We go, oh, I don't really like the template. Okay, so let's go to apply. We'll keep it as was. Eggos taste like heaven. Then we go, so next, we go to authors. It's, remember, it populated that information from the beginning. So now that's still there, Stevie Cabano. Next. Okay, front cover image. We can use one of their images or upload your own. Get your own images taken. Like something that is relevant to the content that's inside, right? Compelling and captivating. So, I don't know. I wonder if we have any pictures on here.
Like if you want to
Oh, look, and a cute liver.
Your kids are on your back, or you can put yourself on the back.
Yep, so back cover text and author photo, that's It's going to show up real soon, and that's where we put that. It's perfect. I'm not going to put a liver.
That was a sample picture, so.
Yeah. I'm going to put a koala. Mm-hmm. Or a jellyfish, perhaps. I mean, what's that even?
Oh, okay.
Look at that. Eggos taste like heaven. Don't taste this Eggo. It'll shock you. Okay, so now we're uploading our image. Do you see how easy this is, you guys? Like, literally, it's going to create a cover, and then, oh my gosh. Okay? So you can also play with alignment, okay? You just see what fits for what you're trying to accomplish. I think I want to go back to it being like that. I don't know. What do you guys thoughts?
Yeah.
We laugh. Okay, cool. Oopsies. All right, so then next, next is puberty. Okay, so then our back cover text. So this is where we talk a little bit about what's inside the book, right? Maybe what compelled us to write it. If you have any endorsements or anything like that that you want to add, here's where you would quote those people and put that in, okay? And so now this is what's going to be on the back. Then your author photo, so you literally just upload your image. This is me, best-selling koala. I always joke that Egos Are Like Farts is gonna be a best smeller. Okay, so then once we do that, and you want like a good quality headshot, right? So then we go, and look, you guys, like literally the book's being created right before your eyes. It's so simple, it is so simple, you guys. Even if you just play with it and get it mailed to you, you're going to be tickled when you are holding on to that. I'm telling you. So then we could change. Let's go back to font color. Oopsie. Or background color, rather. You could change this. Maybe some other colors work better with the image that you've now put in or the image of you, right? Ooh, what do we think? No. What about, what have I done? Nope. And you know what's cool is you could take these and you can screenshot them. You guys get people actively involved in the making of your book. Do a picture that's just the back. Don't even let them see what the back's going to say yet, right? Keep it in all this Latin, right? But screenshot the picture of the cover and the picture of you and the different colors and say, what color do you guys prefer? And get people involved and invested in the process. Every ounce of it, because you'll get free market research. People love to share their opinions. That's what social media is all about. And it's free market research. And now because they were a part of that process with you, they're that much more inclined to invest the day of when you launch, right? So making sure, of course, that you're thanking everyone for their input. So pink is not it. Anne Cabana.
So do you have any concerns about putting out your title?
If you do, then I would say XXX, you know, whatever, coming soon. And then just ask people about the concepts of color and what they're thinking about that with the image and stuff. Yeah. So, and it is something to be mindful of, you know. I wasn't worried about Egos Are Like Farts. I didn't think anyone was even thinking that way. But I could see where your stuff, you want to be mindful of that. Yeah. Okay, cool. So we'll just stick with that for now. Yeah, that color. So then it gives us the option to change design. So right now I'm at 6x9 spineless. Now I might want, oh, that's funny because it's a jellyfish. But let's say you have a textbook and you want a spine, right? You would go ahead and you would anticipate that in the beginning when it asks you about the layout. So maybe now it's time to change it because this is a working document, right? And so it's going to evolve as you evolve. So then we would submit cover. Okay, so then we submit our cover, they verify the uploads and tell us that everything's good, the pixelation. I think the first time I submitted an author photo, they said that the pixelation was poor. And so it was like, are you sure you want to do that? Or do you want to give us something that's a little more higher quality? And so that's what I did. Please make sure you complete all the steps prior to submission. Okay, let's return. I didn't change all that verbiage on the back, so it's still Latin. Okay? So, boop-a-doop. So you would do this whole process, okay? And it'll tell you like where you left off. Like, hey, you messed up here. We still need to complete this. So we go to edit cover. 7 of 8 tasks completed. Notice where there isn't a green mark, where I don't have a green check, right? Isn't it great? It's like rewarding you. A lot of a little green. So, yep, see, it wants us to change this. I don't know why, but that's exactly what I wanted to say on the back of this book. So now we would just put in whatever we want to put in here.
Blah, blah, blah.
Blah, blah, blah. We'll do just that for you, Jeffrey Allen Gray. Blah, blah, blah. Mm-hmm. Thank you, blah. All right, so now we'll apply. Okay, now we got the green, okay? Green means go. So now we'll submit this cover. And I love that it just gives you guys, like, it tells you exactly, I would not have known what to do or how to do any of that, but it just tells us, boop, 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 boop. And you can go on to one step, right, without completing the next. So now it's saying, okay, good to go. This is what it's gonna look like. You can get a full-size preview, so we can click on that. We could start a new cover from scratch, right? Or we can complete the cover. Let's say we were happy with it, we complete the cover. Upload complete. If we want to make changes, now's our time, okay? Not to say that you can't change it in the future. Let's go to save. Okay, so now look at, it's giving us check marks. We've done the title information. We did a free ISBN. We've done the interior, we uploaded that. We've done the cover, that's good to go. So now it's complete setup. So now it asks us again, do you want to make changes? No, we're good, we're gonna continue. So it says, okay, here we go, complete setup. Here's your ISBN, here's the title, subtitle, author, here's the interior you chose. Now, one final stop, do you want to edit? Are you sure you don't want to edit? It's okay, it's not really your final stop. You can always log back in and edit. But nonetheless, it's just making sure, because the next part is when we order it as an author proof. And all we pay is shipping to have it sent to us. That's it. So it's not completely free, it's like $4, okay? I lied to get you all here. Okay, so then we go here to submit files for review. So this is, I wanna say, two like 48 hour processes. So the first one is, they say 24 hours, okay, I believe them. I remember it being 48 hours. I remember waiting, like, I was so excited. So within a matter of 2 days, they'll tell us whether or not everything's printable, whether it looks good, and they email us that the review is complete. I was celebrating that. Like, I was screenshotting that on Facebook. I'm like, oh my God, my file's complete. It was reviewed, it's good. I celebrate every little thing. You guys have to celebrate this entire process. And it's worth celebrating, because you're doing, less than 1% of the world are authors. No one does this. And you can't do it wrong, because it hasn't been done before. You're the first person writing these words into physical manifestation, creating something. Never been done before. You can't do it wrong. So just do it. So then files are being checked. So within 24 hours, I'm going to get some sort of email that's going to say, hey, it's been reviewed. It's good to go. In the meantime, it's asking me about different standard distribution channels. David Dunn.
Do they let you know if your title has been taken? Or would you not pass? At what point would you find out?
That's a good question. They wouldn't tell you that. I would research it. I would type and see if it's been taken. Can't anticipate that y'all's is, but it's worth looking into and seeing what else exists that's similar. And just like movies have had the same titles, I think you get LLCs that differentiate between, you know, or doing business as. I really don't know the answer to that, but perhaps I can look into that further.
You can't search
copyrights. You can search them. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
Yeah, or a trademark, and you can trademark sometimes for as little as $10, and Will Zecco here at the support center for our students, he'll help you look into that. So the Entrepreneur Support Center, that's free, that's part of your tuition, long after you graduate. So look at trademarking, and there's a difference between, you can do trade names, registering, and then there's trademarking, and there's differences. Sometimes trademarking is as much as like $6,000 just to get a lawyer. That's like for Monopoly TM, right? Like, that's different. Look into trade name and registering trade names and see if that a book would qualify and how that falls. I imagine it's a lot like movies.
I've looked into that. There's applying for a trademark at the federal level, which is what most people think about, and that's a lot more involved and a lot more complicated and expensive.
Yeah,
but you can apply for a trademark at the state level. It's a lot cheaper.
Yeah. Well, and at the end of the day, so thank you, Jason. And if your book is on fire and people are loving it because of the content, because you're promoting it, what are the odds that someone's actively promoting something that is the same as yours. I mean, honestly, people don't stay, they don't keep the momentum. That's what's going to separate us from everybody else, is the fact that we're doing the work, that we're showing up, and that we're not letting it stop us, and that every single day we're taking a step towards that green check and that green bubble and having an author proof in our hand. That separates everyone from everyone else, the successful people, the people that show up. So it'd be so rare, I think, that there's even right now, I can't think of two entities that are going head-to-head with the same name.
Well, to have a title and subtitle be the same would
totally
be kind of rare.
Yeah, that is
super
rare.
You can have the same title,
totally,
but just a different sub.
Yep. A great question. And I think you'll be good. I'm also not a lawyer, so my I thinks are not very weighted. Cool. Other questions?
I do.
Jeffrey?
So for your books, you're including workbook type stuff in there.
Yeah, I added questions at the end of each chapter.
So for somebody who's created a book and maybe they have workbook pages at the end, or like pictures and stuff that they want to use, when you put that out, you would obviously probably want to trademark those processes, if it's a process, or maybe
sure,
a picture or your workbook pages.
Sure.
Right?
If
know
that resonates
you
with
do
you.
That?
I didn't. I mean, you guys, I'm telling you, this is basics. Like, I've just been winging it. But I've been having a blast, and I haven't paid a dime, and I've got endorsed by a number one New York Times best-selling author. Like, I'm not a legal. I think that it's smart, and I think that follow your gut. And if that's coming up, perhaps it's divine inspiration to look into that because of the route that you're going. So look into it for sure. It's going to be case by case, of course. With me, I haven't run into any hiccups whatsoever. Nothing.
When everybody starts writing fart books with your pictures,
that's when I'm going to go, this was mine, first and foremost.
Hey, Stevie, when you said I'm not a lawyer, I went, my dad and I'm writing with his.
Well, there you go.
Yeah.
How divine.
Yeah.
How divine. Yeah. Well, yes. Question?
Are you going to tell us now about your sales and how you go about promoting that?
Yeah. Well, yeah.
How do you get your book known out there?
So, first and foremost, this will allow you to, for free, you can distribute to Amazon, Amazon Europe, and the Create Space eStore. So they're going to give you links that you can share with people virtually so that they can download it, so that they can purchase it online, etc. They'll tell you what the royalty is going to be based on the page numbers, okay? So you'll do the math. It'll say, how much do you want to charge it for? You could put $4.99, and they'll say, well, it's this many pages, so it has to be a minimum of $3.16. Like, it'll literally, right here. So let's say I want to do it for $6.99, okay? So I'm going to have them calculate, and this is going to help us then figure out how much we're going to purchase and how much we're going to sell it for in person, right? So we go to calculate. So it begins to calculate the minimum list price for this book, given the amount of pages that we have in it that we just threw together, right? It's got to be at least $3.59, and that's so that everyone's profiting, right, to some degree, at least them with royalties. So I'm like, okay. So then they're saying, at a minimum of $3.59 list price, Amazon's my royalty through Amazon, if someone purchases through Amazon, I'm going to get $2.04. If someone purchases through the Create Space eStore, we're going to get $3.44. Okay?
So hard copy, you mean?
Yep. Well, yes. So this would be hard copy. Mm-hmm.
You will be sending it to them, or will they send a hard copy?
They would send it to them.
They would send it.
Yep. So you're not paying for shipping.
Okay.
Yeah. So now that's one of the things, too, that I've noticed is when, let's say, someone from, like, cousins and family, I would send them books, and they would still, they want to support us, right? So they would send me checks for, like, $10, and that would go towards shipping, you know? I mean, because it really was about that much to just, you know, $6 to, like, send it to them, right? So I really didn't profit, and it's family, right? And I'm like, you better take a picture. Nothing is free. You guys make sure that you get at a minimum a testimonial if you give someone a book for free, that you get reviews, that you get, you know, make sure that if you're going to give your book complimentary, that you're getting something in exchange. Testimonial, review, social media, shout out, something, okay? So when you start to play with these numbers to see how much you can get, and you can change this. You can change this all the time. In fact, just recently, Amazon bumped my book up to like $14.99, and then it went back down to $12.99, and I've only ever had it at $9.99. But Barb at the bookstore, she told me that when they went to look online, it was $14.99, and she said, so we're upping it, Stevie. And she's like, but we're still paying you the $8. I said, okay. So that's, I mean, that's like, you work deals with different places. So one of the first things you're going to do is you're gonna order your author proof. So once you get that email that says it's good to go, they're going to say, okay, are you ready for an author proof? And then when you're done crying, you're going to say, yes. And then you're going to pay shipping, and they'll send it to you. And you're going to get it in this perfect little cardboard box, just enough for one book. And when you're done crying again, you're going to open that up, and you're going to see this thing that you've literally physically manifested. It's incredible. It's the most rewarding experience ever. And so you're holding that, and you think, okay, and you're going to turn it over, and you're going to see, you know, the ISBN, and you're going to see just everything all together. And then you're going to decide, okay, who would best value from this book? So here's three questions I want to leave you guys with, because this is going to help you with your author brand. And as you're creating the book, you want to make sure that you're speaking to these people. So the questions that you want to ask yourself, and this is with any private practice, anything you're offering.
I know, right?
Jeffrey, how many times have you seen these questions?
Only once.
Now we're going to make it relevant to a book, okay? What value does your book bring? Think about that. Every single chapter, all the stories that are in it, what value does it bring? Will people feel relieved? Will they feel at peace? Will they feel inspired? Will they feel enlightened, educated? What value does your book bring? So first think about those words, how it's going to benefit and impact the people that read it, okay? Because once you know this, you're going to ask yourself the next question. The next question is, who benefits the most from the above values? Okay? So now, let's say the value that my book, your book brings is that it entertains and inspires and gives people alternative ways of affecting their health in a positive way, okay? Now, who benefits the most? Well, think about your niche. Who are you writing to? For you, the people who would benefit the most are going to be the people that are most relevant to what you're talking about, the anecdotes that you're sharing. So now we're starting to get an ideal demographic, a niche audience, and we're going, okay, who would benefit the most? It's going to be people that are corporate. It's going to be people that sit in front of a computer all day long. Now, it's not just IT community, but now you're thinking all the different corporate positions that sit in front of a computer all day long, right? So now you're able to expand that a little bit. You're going to think about the people that have survived cancer. You're going to think about the families that have supported those that have been through that, okay? So now we know who benefits the most. And this gets into marketing. The final question, now that we know what value our book brings, the different values, because it's going to be multiple, okay? And don't be shy. Don't be shy. Think about, list all the values your book brings. Think about who benefits the most, different audiences that would benefit. And then, finally, this is where marketing comes in. Where do they congregate? Where do the people that would benefit the most from the values your book offers, where do they hang out? Where do they hang? In the lunchroom. At AA meetings, maybe. At youth groups. At childcare locations, right? Mm-hmm. Like, where would we want to get our book? Airports. There's so many places. If you go to Lucy's Healthy Marketplace or like Grand Orange, I don't even know how to say it. They're like the Grand Orange, that fancy little place. They have a lot of like really interesting, kind of weird novelties. They're very big on supporting local. Changing Hands Bookstore, local, right? So those are different places that you could definitely look into seeing if it's a fit there, okay? So once you know these, then you know where to market. And then what you do is you create, and this will be, I want to do a, David and I talked about, we'll do another one after this where we talk about marketing and cover letters and reaching out to people. So I reach out to Lucy's Healthy Marketplace. I look at their mission statement of the places where I want my book. I look at their mission statement, and then I take verbiage from their mission statement, and then I put it in my cover letter and let them know that I'm just about them. So Elephant Journal is a huge online publication, and they're all about mindfulness. So I tweaked a little bit of my Egos Are Like Farts. Not the book, but I did an article, and I talked about mindfulness as opposed to airing the ego. Like I still used my comedic comparisons, but in my original letter to them saying that I feel I should be featured in your mindfulness piece because I take comedic comparisons and it's all about mindfulness. I kept using their verbiage, and that's what helps them go, oh, well, we gotta have them. We gotta have their book. We gotta have their article. They're right up our alley. Look, they said mindfulness 8 times. She's ours. So one of the greatest things I've learned too is like I get kind of like strategic with this stuff, but why not? And it's free. It costs sweat equity. That's what it costs. It costs looking up parenting magazines. Every parenting magazine that's out there, look it up and get in them. Share little tidbits. Share a chapter. And at the end of your article with tips that are educational or informational or inspiring, give them a little link that for the duration of that month's issue, they can click on your website and they can get access to the first 3 chapters. Like, there's so many ways to play with this, you guys. And so the next workshop I'd like to do is really getting into all the different ways you can market. Setting up, having 1 chapter free available, complimentary for download every month, right? Talking about all the things that, so I'm going to tell you one book that you want to get. This is good. Think Like a Publisher is great. And one of the greatest books ever. It's by Rob Eager. I lent it out. I could kick myself. I don't know where it is. I'll get another one. I don't care. It's old as time, but let me tell you, it's incredible. Rob Eager, How to Sell Your Book Like Wildfire. And why it's so good. Wow, I'm a mess. Can you guys see that? Y'all are the best audience ever. So, How to Sell Your Book Like Wildfire. The entire time, you guys, he tells you about from start to finish all the things we need to be thinking of. Every chapter in and of itself independently should be a mini book. It should have value in and of itself, every chapter. Don't leave people hanging. Give them a nugget even in 1 chapter that they're like, woo, that was good. That was good. So, because that can be a standalone. That can be an opt-in to get people to not only give their email address for that first chapter, but then even moving forward, you can say, when you're ready for the rest of it, you know, it's launching on this day, etc. So, questions?
What is the author's name?
Rob Eager.
Is that E-A?
E-A-G-E-R. Let's look it up, so you can see it. Yeah, Randy Davila.
Stevie, I have a question.
Yes?
Can you answer all future questions in an English accent?
I don't know. Think about it. I got to practice. Rob Eager, How to Sell Your Book Like Wildfire. Let me see if I spelled his last name right. Okay, E-A-G-A-R. So much for marrying him. Okay? E-A-G-A-R. How to Sell Your Book Like Wildfire. It is delicious, you guys. And it's a workbook throughout the whole thing. He talks about, too, making your book a workbook. It looks so old, you guys, but it is good. Look at this. It looks like a matchbook. But it is so good. The Writer's Guide to Marketing and Publicity. And it starts, oh, look, ER. I can marry him. Internet. so good. And he talks about throughout, he has that theme throughout where it's like kindling the fire, which is networking and talking and giving little nuggets of the book ahead of time, right? So I'm telling that book is amazing. Like, it's so good. It's so good. Highly recommend it. Now, Randy Davila, if you're looking to go the traditional publishing route because you feel that in your gut, your spirit, that that's the way to go, he has Hierophant Publishing, Insights USA, and Don Miguel Ruiz, The Four Agreements, Sunny Don Johnston, Casey Miller, our founder of the school, they've been published through him. So if you want to go traditional publishing, I would say get his book because he's telling you exactly what they're looking for before you even submit your manuscript, okay? So, excuse me. So this is great too, and you guys are welcome to thumb through this. You'll see a bunch of my notes and stuff. What other questions do you guys have?
What's the royalty?
Shankar?
In the previous page, you got the royalty for Amazon. And
yeah.
What is the dollar amount? Is it the money that Amazon will take?
Royalty is what we would get paid back.
Based off
that price.
Okay.
So you'll get the difference is what they're going to keep, but the royalty is what we receive.
Okay.
And monthly you'll get it. They'll send it to you via PayPal.
Okay.
They'll do sheets for you.
So if you sell it for $10, we get $384 for us in the remaining day.
If someone orders it through Amazon, mm-hmm. we'll get $384. If they buy it through CreateSpace eStore, we'll get $584. And if we buy the book for $2.15 and then go have a book signing at Sweet House Gifts and Graces and sell it for $10, well, then we profited $7.
Yeah.
85, right? Yeah.
So it
doesn't show you. Listen, I don't do math. I'm a writer. Does that answer your question, Shankar?
Yes, it does. And when they buy it through Amazon.com, you said we don't need to send it to them.
Amazon will send it.
Amazon sends it.
Yep,
so
it's going straight.
And they send it?
Yeah, because it's print on demand. So when there's a demand for it, they print it and they ship it.
Really?
Mm-hmm. So that might be a better option when your folks are long distance and you're like, how can we support you?
Yeah.
Go to Amazon.com or go to createspace.com because I'll get another two books.
Yeah.
You know?
Okay.
But they'll ship it for you.
Printing on demand and shipping, that's fast.
No,
yeah.
So when do you get to see how much it costs you as the publisher or the author to buy the book?
After you get your author proof and you proof it, then that's when it'll say, okay, so this is it, and then it'll say, now you can order copies, and you'll see how much they are. Mm-hmm.
They put a price on it?
Yeah, and it's like...
however much you can do it at the
yeah, I mean, like, mine is $2.15 at 26 pages with a glossy finish. So imagine, or it might be 36 pages. So I don't know how it would calculate from there, but play with it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Worst case scenario, you get... the author proof, you pay like $4 to get it shipped to you. And then you're holding it, and you make any revisions you want to make, you know?
Mm-hmm.
But that's like super exciting. When you're holding it, and then you go, okay, and this cost me however much to have it sent to me, easy day.
Mm-hmm.
I know. I love that you have your manuscript, Teresa. That's awesome. Elise.
How often, you get your author proof and you have revisions,
mm-hmm.
So you go back out through this whole process,
mm-hmm.
Since you've gone to author proof, do you have to start over again?
Nope. Until you decide to publish it after the author proof, you would have to start over with a new title and kind of resubmit. The author proof is meant specifically for that reason, so it would just literally, you'd log back in and you'd go to edit any area you wanted to edit, and then go back through the, okay, now I'm ready to do the author proof.
Do they have any kind of ceiling on how many times they let you do that?
I don't know. I don't think so. It's a working document.
As far as, you know, they're going to send it to you, so they're...
Well, you're paying to have it sent to you,
yeah,
shipping-wise. Yeah, I don't know. It'd be worth asking, but I don't think there's caps. And I'm glad that you brought up that question, Elise, because one of the things that I did... Can I erase these questions?
Yeah.
One of the things I did that I would love for you guys to consider is I actually didn't have many revisions because, again, I'm a penny pincher, And I wanted to think of ways that I could make sure that it was like pristine and, you know, like typing and no edit, like issues or errors. Have a book polishing party. And this is where you give friends that are interested, maybe demographic that is more up your alley because you want to get their feedback. Give people a chapter each. They don't get the whole shebang. They don't get the whole enchilada. But give them a chapter, which as a standalone should be compelling enough, right? Give them a chapter and let them go through and make any edits and revisions. And then you have a book polishing party where they come back. You guys gather around for cheese and crackers, whatever. And everyone gives their insights about what they got from the chapter without giving too much away. And what I did was I put them in the acknowledgments. And I just said, thank you so much for, you know, for those who helped me write this book. And that alone, they were tickled. They loved it. So just even having, you know, someone kind of say like, oh, typo here. I don't like this verbiage. And you take it or leave it. Sometimes you go, you know what? I don't really care for, that's not my demographic. They said they were willing to look at, and I wanted their eye for the editing, but I didn't necessarily, I'm not speaking to them, so I'm not going to change that verbiage because I know my audience. So maybe get a bunch of different people from different demographics that you would benefit from having that free market research from all these different places. Had I had a 60 to 72-year-old in my book polishing party, I would have known right then that was my market. But I didn't. I went with all my peers here, which was great, and I was talking about ego, so there was a lot of, like, feedback, like, I don't know if you should use that word. Maybe you should use consciousness. Maybe, you, and so I realized that maybe next time I should go out a little bit from this demographic that's used to hearing it. Go to the demographic that is going to value the most from it and see what they say. See what they walk away with. And you could potentially use that, too, as a testimonial on the back because it's not printed yet. So you could put on the back, like, someone's one sentence or two sentences about this was an epic read, I needed this so much, or what have you, and ask their permission to, you know, quote them. So, does that help, Elise?
Yeah.
Cool.
I
Jeffrey Allen Gray.
When you were going through the pages, suppose you are pulling quotes from people or different topics. I didn't see a page in there for any of that. You just add that your own?
Mm-hmm.
Your own?
Okay. Like on the back cover? Or, oh, in the Microsoft Word document,
yeah.
I literally just hit enter, and then I would write what Eckhart Tolle had said, and then just hyphen Eckhart Tolle, quotation. Yep, I literally typed it. How it's in Microsoft Word document is how it will be inputted. It's
but I mean, like
same
a
with
bibliography
pictures.
Or anything like that, if you're like pulling, like if you're doing quotes for like a research
mm-hmm.
or.
You would, however you would do it in Microsoft Word.
Study, okay, so you would just
yep.
type it yourself and put it in there.
Yeah, mm-hmm. And I would look at maybe, because I don't know the answer to the fonts that kind of go with that, but I imagine just looking up like common fonts for
yeah.
glossary or indent, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Yes.
I'm going to be bold. I'm dyslexic, so I would have to find someone that actually can go in and reframe those words that are
yeah.
on the
ask
page.
A buddy. Book polish party.
Yeah.
People would be honored. People innately we want to help each other. You know? Find a book buddy within here. Hold each other accountable. You know, set some dates and some goals. Elise?
Well, speaking of dyslexia, because I also have dyslexia, so the thing is that what I learned in my first bout of learning to read properly
mm-hmm.
is that all books have a format, and depending on what type of book it is, the important parts of the page are in different places on that page. So you have to really know, depending on your audience
mm-hmm.
and the intention of your book,
mm-hmm.
how to format your page.
And I'm sure that stuff you can Google. This is going to be sweat equity as opposed to money. It's not
you
about
can.
The
I
dime,
just
it's
to bring
time.
That up
yeah, it's
it
brilliant.
A
textbook
a romantic,
writer, especially.
If you're writing a romantic novel, you're going to write differently than if you're
mm-hmm.
writing a technical novel.
Yeah, so maybe even looking up, that's great, Elise, you know, CreateSpace is limited to what they're offering. There's a reason that it's free, that you can choose a free option. But definitely, utilize resources and reach out to people who have already done it. Look at what's already in existence and see what that looks like and then just create it that way.
You might be able to find that, like, in speed reading, because that's That's what I was trained in speed reading,
mm-hmm.
or to read particular books differently.
Oh.
So you might be able to utilize that in speed reading.
Love it. Thanks, Elise. Yeah. Jean?
I heard a tip on content, but I just wanted to share with the group, because
mm-hmm.
I thought it was brilliant. If you've got a particular topic, go out to Amazon and look at similar topics to yours and look at all the reviews and see what people don't like.
Right.
And do what they
yep.
need.
Adopt
yeah.
and
yeah.
adapt.
Mm-hmm.
What works, make it yours.
Right.
Or, you know, let it go if it doesn't. Yeah? Love it. Any other questions? Thank you guys so much for coming. I hope you found this of value. It's very basic, but I'm telling you guys, if you do nothing else, please, please, please just at least log into CreateSpace. Do yourself the favor. Take the time. Log into CreateSpace and tell them Stevie sent you. I'm just kidding. There's no kickback. I know nothing about the I just wanted to share with you guys how easy this has been. It's so easy to literally get a book in your hands. And so if nothing else, that formatted template, it's almost already all there. Just plug that in. I don't care if you throw quotes in there. Pull cards. Throw quotes in there. Print it. You made a book. But I'm telling you, it's like tattoos. They're addictive. Once you make a book and you're holding it, I'm telling you guys, like, it's amazing. So, let me put my email up here for you guys if you have questions, because I would love your questions to help me further support you in your journey, and I'll create content that will help answer those. Stevie at StevieAnne.com, and I'll create content that absolutely supports that for follow-up workshops. David, are we done recording?
Yes.